Okay, let's go to some comments. Maybe I'll combine three comments. Let's start with Hassan, Hassan Adan in Kenya. He says, is it true that African politics is seen as a source of wealth for most politicians? And maybe first respond to that.
And you know what? There are some who have argued, oh, this also happens in other parts of the world. But the truth is, in many African countries today, the quickest way to getting extremely wealthy is to join politics. Mm-hmm. If you succeed in becoming a president, if you become a governor, you come become a senator, you automatically have access to wealth. And how is this wealth acquired? Again, you can tie it to what we just talked about, corruption, because this is wealth that comes by literally taking easy money from government coffers, by taking land that belongs to the public, to the citizens of a country, and personalizing it. And we have seen this across the continent of Africa. So many people now aspire, in fact, to join politics because it's the easiest way to become a wealthy person without working so hard.
Mm. Yeah. Let's stay on corruption. Now let's go to Precious Abagan from Nigeria. I believe the corruption level in Nigeria is steadily rising. President Buhari does not seem to be fighting corruption. What do you think about that, Vincent, especially in light of the fact that when President Buhari was campaigning, he campaigned on the platform of fighting corruption. And to this day, corruption is still very, very prevalent in Nigeria.
We have to acknowledge that just like a number of countries, corruption is a major cancer. But corruption in Nigeria is monumental. And of course, Buhari came to power vowing to fight corruption. To his credit, one has to be fair to Buhari. Just May itself, there was an announcement of about 603 convictions on corruption in Nigeria. That was like more than double the convictions that were reported during the time of the former president, Jonathan Goodluck Jonathan. Buhari has tried up to this point to really fight corruption. It is under his leadership that we've seen the Economic Commission, or rather the Economic and Financial Crimes Commission of Nigeria, convict a former governor to have him sentenced to 12 years in prison for corruption. And there are so many, when you go through, if you've been paying attention to what's going on in Nigeria, under his leadership, there has been judges, politicians, powerful men who have not only been arrested and charged, but whose monies, the monies that they saved in overseas accounts, has been repatriated. Now, to be fair, given the enormity of the issue in Nigeria, given the population of that country and how long this corruption has been going on, he's kind of just scratching the very surface of it. But he has shown the propensity to fight corruption. Now, what will determine whether his will be considered a successful war? It will be how consistent and persistent he will be, at least throughout his leadership. By the end of it, he may not eliminate corruption, but it may probably entrench a culture of no tolerance to corruption.
But how about the people who say that this could actually cost him a re-election because there are a lot of people who are not eating,
if I might use that word. And that is the biggest challenge of fighting corruption, because there's so much pushback. Remember, corruption is all about stealing. People use these words, corruption, misappropriation, and whatever. It is about stealing public funds. Now, there's so many people who want to steal. There's so many people who want to get this easy.
Is it just about stealing public funds?
You steal public funds, you take public land, you take government properties. There are places where people have literally taken houses and buildings that used to belong to the government and take them and then personalize them and sell them. And because they have seen how others have benefited from that, they also want to benefit. So they resent any politician, any leader who may come and try to fight against that kind of effort for them to acquire easy wealth. And so you can understand, it's a fight that could lead to deaths. A person could actually be killed for trying to fight corruption. Mm. So one has to understand that it's not an easy war. And Buhari, of course, to his credit, I think there's something he has been doing. But he may not necessarily win this war, not today, but he probably will start a war, something somewhere.